Hello and welcome students. In my last video, I explained to you what is a cell wall, a plasma membrane, cytoplasm and the nucleus, and also the difference between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Now we will see that what all is present inside the cell. As I said, the cell is the structural and functional unit of life. That means the cell performs all the activities of an organism. Whatever we do, nutrition, the food we store, the energy we store, everything is present in each cell, which is responsible to help us in performing different activities. Now, if we look at a cell, we see the nucleus in the center. There is the cytoplasm, and along with the cytoplasm, there are certain smaller organ-like structures present inside the cytoplasm. Why did I say organ-like structure? Organ-like structure because they are performing like organs, but they are not organs. They are something like organs. So we call them as cell organelles. Now, in case of cell organelles, there are many cell organelles that we have to study. Now, if we look at the cell, we will see that they are present and suspended, and they keep moving inside the cell because of the presence of the cytoplasm. The first cell organelle that we are going to study is the endoplasmic reticulum, which is also known by the short form ER. Endoplasmic reticulum, its main function is to transport the things within the cell. Whatever has to be transported, it is within the movement within the cell. This endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. One is smooth and the other is rough. Why rough and smooth? In the rough one, it is simply present, and in the smooth one, it is simply present, and in the rough one, there are small granules attached to it. These granules are the granules of ribosomes. These ribosomes, which are useful for the synthesis of protein. The main function of endoplasmic reticulum is transport, preparation or making of proteins. This also makes fat, and also it helps in cleaning the toxins within the cell. Toxins get accumulated in the cell due to various reasons, what we breathe, what we eat, or the side effects of medicine. So all that is cleaned up by the endoplasmic reticulum. Then comes Golgi apparatus. This Golgi apparatus can also be called by the name Golgi bodies or Golgi complex. Their main function is to stack up the things. They act like racks for the cell. Whatever is there, they stack it up, and they help in preserving, and whenever it is needed by the cell or the body, they give it out. They also help in packaging. That means, as per the requirement of the body, they supply the things. They have another important function, that is, they make another cell organelle called the lysosomes. These lysosomes are made by the Golgi apparatus. And these lysosomes are said to be the suicidal bags of the cell. They secrete a digestive enzyme which engulfs the whole cell, kills the cell, and is replaced by a new cell. In the process, they themselves kill their own cell organelle. So it is said to be suicidal bags. Then we come to the next one, that is mitochondria. Whatever amount of energy is produced by the breakdown of food and oxygen, or you can say oxidation of food, that energy is stored in one of the cell organelles called the mitochondria. This mitochondria is called the powerhouse of cell, and it stores the energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. Next, we come to the vacuoles. Vacuoles are present in almost all cells, but they are more prominent in plant cell. They are in the center and they contain the cell sap. They store the cell sap. The moment the waste is accumulated, they throw out, and finally they take the place again for the next lot of waste. In case of animal cells, the vacuoles are present. If they are present, they will be on the periphery of the cell. Periphery means at the side of the cell. In plant cell, this is in the center, and in animal cell, it is at the periphery, at the side. They may be absent also in case of animal cells. And after the vacuoles, next one that we study is the centrioles. Centrioles are that cell organelle which is present only in animal cell, and they help in cell division. They are not found in plant cell. The next one that we are going to study is the plastids. The plastids are present only in plant cell. We do not find them in any animal cell. They are of three types: the leucoplast, then the chloroplast, and the chromoplast. These plastids, since they show different colors, they have been called by the different names. The plastid which is present in the roots, which actually stores some amount of proteins and fats, are said to be leucoplast, and they are colorless in their color. That means they don't have color and they are present in the roots. The chloroplast, as the name suggests, chloro means related to chlorophyll. And this is present in the green areas of the plants, that is the leaf or the green part of the stem. And it imparts only green color to the leaves. The third one, that is the chromoplast, which is present in the flowers and fruits. The various colors of fruits or the flowers that you see, that is because of the presence of chromoplast. So these plastids, which are imparting color to various parts of the plant, are absent in animal cell, and the centrioles, which help in division of cell in animals, is absent in plant cell.